He's played a teenage wizard, a handsome vampire, and has been in countless independent productions. Robert Pattinson's film career is as varied as they come.
He's also a star of Netflix productions in both The King and The Devil All the Time, both of which are streaming now.
Let's take a look at his prolific road to Netflix. Cast your mind back to 2004 and you'll find a fresh-faced Pattinson's earliest on-screen roles, including a supporting role in a German made-for-TV film, Ring of the Nibelungs.
Don't the old ways fascinate you?
But believe it or not, another of Pattinson's earliest film credits never actually made it to the big screen. He starred in Vanity Fair alongside Reese Witherspoon as an older version of her character's son.
She's here to claim me as her own.
You are her own.
I bear you no ill will, madam. But it's too late to play the mother now.
The scenes he starred in were cut from the film and only appeared on the DVD version. But, as he told W Magazine in 2017, the casting director felt so guilty, she gave him the first run on a role in a certain British wizarding franchise.
The Hogwarts champion, Cedric Diggory! Yeah!
That's right, perhaps if Pattinson had never been cut from Vanity Fair, we may never have seen his Cedric Diggory in Harry Potter and the Goblet of Fire.
You know the prefect's bathroom on the fifth floor? It's not a bad place for a bath. Just take your egg and mull things over in the hot water.
The handsome Triwizard Tournament contestant plays an important role as a rival for Harry's crush, but more unfortunately, as a newly risen Voldemort's first victim. His next film was a psychological thriller, which aired on BBC 4 in 2006, where he played an RAF lieutenant paralysed during World War II. He's sent to rest at a creepy hospital in the Welsh countryside, and things inevitably start going a bit pear-shaped. His role in 2007's The Bad Mother's Handbook couldn't have been more different. The ITV film starred Pattinson as a geeky kid with a crush on a pregnant teenager.
You might feel queasy, very hungry. You might even feel quite sexually aroused.
Is he looking?
Now, 2008 was a big, big year for Pattinson. He had a role in a comedy drama about a 20-something having a quarter-life crisis in How to Be.
This is Dr. Ellington. He's going to make me be more normal. Very, very famous, very, very successful.
And Spanish surrealist artist Salvador Dali in Little Ashes.
Morality, immorality, good, bad, we have to smash that to pieces.
But it was another 2008 role which turned him into an overnight Hollywood star.
I know what you are.
Say it. Out loud. Say it.
Vampire.
That's right. 2008 was the first time we saw Pattinson as Edward Cullen, alongside Kristen Stewart's Bella Swan in the blockbuster film version of teen vampire series Twilight. It was wildly successful and cemented Pattinson's place in Hollywood. He reprised the role in four more films. New Moon in 2009, Eclipse in 2010, Breaking Dawn Part 1 in 2011, and Part 2 in 2012. In between filming the Twilight movies, he starred in some romantic dramas, including 2010's Remember Me.
I don't date sociology majors.
Lucky for you, I'm undecided.
And in 2011, he starred alongside Reese Witherspoon again, this time as her love interest, in Water for Elephants. But by 2012, Pattinson was moving away from big-budget films and towards independent productions, helmed by some of the film industry's biggest artistic names. For example, he worked with David Cronenberg twice. Once in 2012, playing a ruthless billionaire in Cosmopolis.
I'm losing money by the ton.
And again in his satirical film Maps to the Stars, as a limousine driver slash struggling actor.
Havana, this is Jerome.
I'm a big fan.
Aww. Across the next few years, he continued to draw rave reviews for his performances in independent productions. And those roles were about as far away from a sparkling vampire as you can get. like in 2015 when he played Lawrence of Arabia in Queen of the Desert.
Ah, this particular schoolboy has a PhD in archaeology.
Thompson, I have a PhD in medieval pottery shards, and it follows me around like the wafting of an old spinster's fart.
Or in 2016, when he became British explorer Henry Costin in The Lost City of Z. Then there's 2017's heist movie Good Time, in which he plays a bank robber trying to free his developmentally disabled brother from Rikers Island after a job gone wrong.
You're fucking incredible. You're incredible, do you understand?
Yeah.
No, I'm serious. You guys could have done that without you standing next to me being strong.
One of his more surreal roles came in 2018's High Life. It's a non-linear thriller set in space, on a ship filled with criminals being experimented on. Oh, and the ship is heading towards a black hole with a kid in tow.
What you doing, brother?
Another psychological thriller was Robert Eggers' The Lighthouse, a black and white film shot in an almost square aspect ratio. Alongside Willem Dafoe, Pattinson plays one of two lighthouse keepers losing their grip on sanity after a storm strands them on the remote island they're stationed on.
To 4 weeks.
That same year, Pattinson made his Netflix debut in The King, playing the deranged Dauphin of France with some unforgettable lines.
I mean, no, your balls must be big, no? Giant balls. Giant balls with a tiny cock.
Now we're up to 2020, when we see Pattinson's return to big-budget films in Christopher Nolan's mind-bending Tenet.
Well, I've seen too much.
Meanwhile, he's currently filming the starring role in The Batman, slated for release in 2021. But 2020 also marks his return to Netflix in The Devil All the Time, an adaptation of the novel by Donald Ray Pollock. He's playing an unconventional and possibly unholy preacher in this one.
Blessed are they who hunger and thirst for righteousness.
That ain't no preacher. He's as bad as they got on the damn radio.
Starring alongside some other faces you might recognize.
There's a lot of no good sons of bitches out there.
Excuse me, preacher. You got time for a sinner?
Lucky for you, that's now streaming on Netflix. Make sure you don't miss it. What's your favorite Pattinson film? Let us know in the comments, and if you want more videos like this, make sure you subscribe to the channel.